Hi all, this is Chroma Hands. Today I'm going to talk about my latest upgrade kit, which is for Cybertron Optimus Prime Savage Claw mode. This also works with Megatron, but we can talk about this later. So as you know, when Leobreaker transforms into Savage Claw mode, he doesn't get a hand with moving fingers like in the show. And this is what this upgrade kit is for, is to give him fingers and articulation so he can grab onto something. Pose however you like. So there are two parts to this kit. The first part is this section in gray, which combines to form the actual hand. And then there's a part two of this kit, which are these claw extensions, which augment the cyber teeth claws. This hand upgrade part is available in gray only, and it kind of matches to the toy. So you don't need to apply any paint to this. For the claw, however, it would depend on which toy you have. For example, if you have Nemesis Breaker, where the claw is gray, I will offer the claw upgrade in gray, which is a matching color, so don't need to apply any paint to it. However, for Leobreaker, the claws are in orangey brown, and unfortunately, Shapeways doesn't apply any matching color to it. So I'm going to offer this in white, and you'll have to apply color on your own. And let's talk about the hand upgrade first. So for the hand upgrade kit, it will arrive in many different parts. And the first thing we should talk about is the fingers. So there are four fingers and a thumb. Each finger is composed of three different joints. So for the four fingers, the first joint is a ball joint, followed by two other thumb joints. The same thing applies to the thumb. And for the two smaller finger joints, they're very similar. So I should talk about the differences between the two so you don't mix them up. So this is the thumb, and this is the small fingers. As you can see, for the fingertips, the thumb is longer and the fingers are shorter. And also for the four fingers, fingertip has a hole in the middle. And for the second finger joint, you can see a groove in here. These are for the four fingers. While for the thumb, there's no groove. So make sure when you assemble the thumb, is the first joint, which resembles this part, followed by a second joint that has no grooves, followed by a longer finger that has no hole at the front. And for the four fingers, a ball joint, followed by a middle joint with a groove on the side, followed by a smaller finger tip joint, which has a hole at the tip. And then there are these two pieces which combines to form the palm of the hand, and this T-shaped piece, this is where you attach the claws onto. So let's assemble everything together to form the hand. So first, let's take this piece. This attach to the back of the claws. Just like that. Just make sure the cyber keyholes are facing out. And let's put this aside, and let's talk about these parts. So this top part here that sticks out, you attach this to here, so it hinges at the top. And then on here, you put the thumb part in there. And then you put the other side of the palm part together. And on here, this is where you put the four fingers in. These ball joints will wear off in time and the joint will be loose. So if it becomes loose, apply some nail polish. So this is basically what the hand looks like by itself. And at the top here, there's a peg hole right in the middle. If you like to, you can put the whip tail here. And now the hand is ready to combine with Leobreaker. So let's take Leobreaker. Get ready to be like this. Swing the lower thigh up and then fold the legs. You see here, there are two holes in here. This is gonna attach to these pegs right here. And there you go. So let's talk about hand articulation. So the thumb can fold up and down, and it can also swivel a little bit. The four fingers are attached to a ball joint, so you can spread them and pose however you want. Let me just fold this into a fist. And pointing finger, let's close this index finger. There's your fist. The hand is big enough to hold small objects if you wish. So I have a pen here. Let's grab this. And right now, this is the right hand. You can easily interchange this between left hand and right hand by simply flipping this thumb part the other way around. So the easiest way to do this is to split the hand in half just by spreading the legs. Remove the thumb part and insert it the other way. And then assemble the thing back together. And there you go, the left hand. Now let's talk about the claws. So these two claws are attached to the T-shaped part as mentioned earlier. And they can swivel together as one piece. And what I like to do when you're not using the claw, I just fold these fingers in so it doesn't interfere with the articulation of the hands. But let's say if you want to deploy the claws, so let me just unlock the claws first. There you go. You can now adjust the tilt and angle by tweaking how the fingers land against the claws and how this whole piece swivels against the hand. So you can make the claw kind of like this, or if you prefer a more Wolverine look where the claw is aligned flat with the hand, you can swivel the whole thing to the front. Like this. And if you feel the claws still look a bit too short, this is where these pieces come in. These are claw extensions that augment the claws. So to assemble this, you see here, there's a little vertical bar between the three claws. So you just snap the piece right in there like that. That's it. Now let's do it for the other claw. There you go. And again, you can change the angle and tilt as you wish, depending on the pose. You can make it angle like that. You can put it up and down. Oops. And of course, you can fold it back if you want. And doesn't interfere with the locking mechanism. And now, let's assemble this to Optimus Prime. So this is Optimus Prime, Savage Claw mode, with the hand upgrade and the claw extension. As mentioned before, you can adjust the tilt and angle of the claws as you wish. You can make it align closer to the fist, more like Wolverine style, or you can make it a bit more separate if you wish. All you need to do is just adjust the swivels on here and Leobreaker's fingers. And finally, here's what it looks like with Megatron, or I should say Galvatron, and Nemesis Breaker in Savage Claw mode. I know I mentioned this before, but I'm gonna say it again. These claws are available in gray as well. So it really depends on which variant of Leobreaker you're trying to upgrade. If it's Nemesis Breaker, then just directly order the claws in gray and you don't need to worry about painting. But for Leobreaker, you should order white and then apply some color yourself. So the hand upgrade also has its uses for Leobreaker on its own, in both robot mode and beast mode. So the hand upgrade, you can transform it to form arm shoulder cannons, which can attach to Leobreaker. So to do this, split this in half again, remove the thumb piece and the claw attachment piece, and then fold the fingers 90 degrees. And you notice that there's a little tiny peg here. This attaches to this screw hole right here. Same with the other side. And switch it to back. And the remaining two pieces, you can just attach them to the peg holes at the back. Shoulder cannons. And needless to say, you can attach the claw extensions as is. And for beast mode, attaches the same way. Again, screw hole right here at the top. shoulder cannons. And this can also tilt slightly as you wish.
And I'd like to give you guys a small update. I have since taken the white claws and paint them into a color that's closer to Leobreaker's original claw brown color. I think my camera isn't doing the paint any justice, but in reality, the color of the painted claws is much closer, matches closer to the toy color. So for those who don't know which paint to apply to, if you have a Leobreaker, this is what I got yesterday from Michael's. It costs about $1 to $2 only, so I think it's a pretty close match, not exact match, but pretty close match to Leobreaker's claw colors. So if you are unsure what paint to get to apply the brown color, I would go to Michael's, pick this up, and it's a good starting point. And so here is Leobreaker by himself, fully upgraded with the arm cannons and the claw extensions painted. And the paint dries pretty quickly, maybe 1 or 2 hours, so maybe one coat or two coats is enough. So I'll give you a quick turntable. Leobreaker upgraded. And here's what it looks like with Optimus and Leobreaker in Savage Claw mode. But instead, the claws are now painted as opposed to white. So give a more close-up shot. Swing arms down a little bit so it's easier to see. Okay, good. So now we focus. Let me snap back the claws. So that's pretty much it for this upgrade. Hope you guys enjoyed this. This is Chroma Hands. Thanks for watching.